In this video, I will explain on three types of pressure indicators for ESA ATPL instrumentation examination. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. Focus of this channel is to provide solutions for ESA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comment section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish new video. In this video, I will explain on manifold pressure, MAP indicator, engine pressure ratio, EPR indicator, and oil pressure indicator. Now let's examine manifold pressure indicator. This indicator is also known as boost gauge. It is a direct reading type and calibrated to measure absolute pressure in inches of mercury. This pressure is representative of that produced at the induction manifold of a supercharged piston engine. This indicator gives indication of engine power. Illustrated on the screen is the mechanism of a typical indicator. This system consists of two bellows, mechanical lever, gear, dial, and scale. In this system, two bellows make up the measuring element, one open to the induction manifold and the other evacuated and sealed. Controlling spring fit inside the sealed bellow. Expansion or contraction of the bellow will be sensed and transferred via mechanical lever and gear, which will turn the dial and give the indication. When pressure applies to the open bellow, it will expand. This expansion will move the lever, which will turn the gear and dial and give reading on indicator. When aircraft climb, the reduction in atmospheric pressure will cause the open bellow to expand. This tendency is counteracted by the closed bellow, which will expand in the opposite direction. The overexpansion of the open bellow is counteracted by the closed bellow by the same amount. This cancels out the effect of atmospheric pressure during climb and descent. Engine pressure ratio. This system consists of an engine inlet pressure probe, a number of pressure sensing probes located in the exhaust unit of the engine, a pressure ratio transmitter, and an indicator. Shown on the screen is the interconnection of these components based on a typical system. The inlet pressure P1 sensing probe is similar to a pitot probe and is mounted so that it faces into the airstream in the engine intake. Pipeline terminating at manifold interconnect the exhaust pressure sensing probe in order to average out the pressure. A pipeline from the manifold and another from the inlet pressure probe is each connected to the pressure ratio transmitter. The indicators may be of the servo type or electronic display system. The indication will be the ratio between P2 and P1 or P2 over P1. Oil pressure gauge. The oil pressure gauge is the most important gauge for satisfactory engine operation. If the oil pressure fails, bearing failure occurs quickly. The face of the gauge has a green arc showing the normal pressure range, a yellow arc for the caution range, and a red line for maximum oil pressure. It is important that the oil pressure register on the gauge within 30 seconds of the engine starting. Metal capsule or diaphragm are normally used as sensor for measuring oil and fuel pressure. These connect by an electrical transmission system to the indicator on the flight deck. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any question or comment about pressure indicators or any ATPL or aviation related question, you can leave them in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.